Can I airdrop it to you? All right, I think we're live. All right, what's up, guys? All right, welcome. Okay, I need to send Andy a file real quick, so this is gonna just be just a second before we get to painting. Let's see here, Tops Project 70. Excuse me, Buster Pussy Print. Okay, you have airdrop? New Finder window here. Airdrop. Andy. So I realize I think I need one more stencil layer. I'm not done cutting the stencil. It's right there, which is actually behind me back there. So I have two cameras today. Can't really see. Okay, so there's one right there that is going to be capturing all the art that we're get to do. And then we have this one, obviously. Okay, so tonight we're going to paint Buster Posey. If you guys saw, I've cut out a few of the stencil layers. I still have to cut out a couple more. I was hoping to have those done by the time the stream started, and I didn't get those done, so that's okay. They're going to be pretty quick. But yeah, I'm just planning on playing music and painting tonight, however long it takes, and try and finish the Buster card completely, start to finish, blank canvas to completion, which would be awesome. And I'll probably be kind of to and from, let's see, let me pull back up YouTube so I can see comments if I put that up here. Oh, where'd it go? Sorry guys, bear with me, we're figuring it out. So if I go to YouTube Studio here. There we go. So also, if you guys might have noticed, I changed the layout just like where my desk is. My desk used to be this direction, so I used to look that way and be able to see. That's kind of where we do our painting. That's our window with the fan, all our spray paint cabinets and stuff. We decided to switch it and put the desk here so that we have a much sweeter background. And that way it's all just like one sight line to like where we paint also, which is cool. All right, let's see here. Let's check in with the comments real quick. Octavio, Donna, Grant, Matt, Dustin. So Dustin is in, Dustin Bradford in the chat. He's the photographer who took the photo of Buster Posey that I'm painting tonight. And I met him through Project 2020 and YouTube and blowout forums and whatnot. So that's really cool. What's up, Dad? Adam. Jason. Sam Cam. Nice. Brian. Yay, Jackson's there. What's going on, guys? What's up, Jackson? That was a great foil. Jackson pulled a foil of Naturel Juan Soto today, and he knew right away that it was a foil, which is awesome. Okay, so like I said, I gotta do a little bit of cutting. I'm gonna be kind of back and forth. Really busy corner. You know, there'll be periods where I might be off camera or whatever, but I will just try. I'm just trying to knock out this painting as much as possible. I just want to let you guys in on the process. So I will try and check in every so often and say what's up to you guys, or talk to you guys about what I'm doing, or answering questions if you guys want to keep questions going. Yeah, Heavy J, he got the gold Justin Turner, which is amazing. What's up, Donna? RJ. How's it going, man? Yeah, so we're going to get to painting. Like I said, we're going to take it from a blank canvas all the way up to a finished piece, hopefully. And you guys can stay as long as you want. It is going to take a little time. We're going to have to wait for paint to dry and stuff in between. I have to cut a little bit more on the stencils, but you guys will get to see it here first. And I mean, the stencils that I've already cut look sick. The card's going to be awesome. I'm very, very excited about it. Let's see here. So if I go to, where's my Buster Posey folder? Here we go. So we're doing 1971 inspired Buster Posey. All right, well, I guess we should get to it. Yeah, Posey is a good choice. Thank you, guys. What's up, Kristen? That's okay. You haven't missed anything yet. We're just, we're still getting set up. I'll get the canvas. So, let's see here. One, it's my face tracking thing. Oh well, I don't know if I can really stop that. One thing I'm doing differently with this project versus Project 2020 is I'm painting a lot bigger. These are 30 by 40 canvases. Well, my second card is coming out on Monday. 15th, that one is on wood, but it's the same size, 30 by 40, which is a whole lot bigger than the Project 2020 cards. Probably not, just during the stream. Need to hear it. Yeah, so we're going big, which I think is awesome. It means the end body of work will be a very big statement piece, which I think is really cool. Just checking in on these comments. Sam Cam, what's going on? Jason Miller, Derek, Tim, how you doing, man? Tim's been killing it at Top Shot. Donna, Kev. Yeah, what's going on, guys? Okay, let's see here. I'm just wondering, so this is like tethered to the computer. I wish I could take you with me over there while I cut that stencil. But I can't get that close. Let's see here. Maybe we could just try to get a little closer. Sorry, guys. Getting an intimate tour of the studio right now, too. Okay. Well, technically, it is closer. And then we have the canvas right there. All right, well, I just have to cut this, so I'm just going to go cut it. You guys talk amongst yourselves. You know what actually would be really cool is... I'm going to tweet. You get. I assume a lot of you guys were here when we were doing the giveaways. I think that was last Monday or last Wednesday or something. My thinking is I'm going to write a tweet right now telling people I'm about to paint Buster Posey. If you guys will retweet that, I'll give something to random retweet. I'll pick some retweet winners. I'll pick three of them. Which picking retweet winners is way easier than picking Instagram winners, as it turns out. Okay, Twitter, here, tweet. Come hang live and watch me paint Buster Posey. It's also great because if you guys all retweet this, then maybe Buster will see it. Maybe he'll join. For tops, hashtag Project70. It's going down. Here, right now. Bam. Oh, that is the stream code. Okay, so if I go to my channel, my channel. the link address. Here, back to Twitter. It's going down here right now. It's going down right now. We don't have to delete. We can get rid of the here. Come hang live. Watch me paint Buster Posey for tops. Hashtag Project70. It's going down right now. Tweeted. Okay, now, if I go to my tweets, and I go here, copy link to tweet, and then we go here to the chat. Here we go. So, Tim, actually, funny thing about the Yogi Bear, I'll tell you in a second. Okay, that I just shared a Twitter link. That's a tweet just saying, I'm about to paint Buster Posey right now. Come join. If you guys go retweet that, I will, throughout the night, I will pick three different winners, and they're going to win some something. I don't know what it is going to be yet, but it's always awesome stuff, so it'll be good. Yeah, so Tim asking about other artists painting Yogi Berra. It's interesting because he must have been a very late addition to like Topps getting the rights, because originally he was not on the list of players that we were given. And there were a handful of players like that. Like Doc Ellis, for example, was not on the list. I requested him. They were able to get those rights. He's on my list. So Yogi Berra must have been the similar case for somebody, some other people. Anyways, myself, I didn't know that we could paint Yogi Berra until literally when that card came out. And also, side note, I'm a huge Ron English fan. I have a signed print of his, of what's that number, to 150 in the kitchen. Very cool artist. Highly recommend you check out his stuff. I think his Yogi card is pretty cool. I think a lot of his art and his potential is even higher than that. So, yeah. Okay. Nice. Yeah, Doc Ellis will be awesome. Okay. So I need to cut this stencil. You guys talk amongst yourselves or go retweet that. Help get some people in the room. And then we're going to paint. Andy, is it printing? I'm also going to check and see if that's printing, because I am going to need at least one more stencil layer for us to really do our magic. I'll be right back. I'm going to show you guys real quick. Actually, I can show you here. This is the photo that I'm referencing. Bam. So right now, I'm over there. I'm cutting out the orange. And I'm almost done with it. And then I'm going to have to do another layer that's going to be the gray. But that'll be very fast. I got to do another layer that's skin. That'll be very fast. Because I'm just talking big general shapes. It's like the midtones. And then I'm also using stencils to do like a white layer and a black layer, which is going to kind of give it all the depth. So I have to do kind of these midtones. And then also, because we are doing, man, I wish I had a reference card of, what is it, 71, 72? Which was also a heritage set. Anyways, it's got the black border. And then kind of within the black square border, there's like a white kind of rounded border, thinner one, which we're going to have to like mask off. F dot in the house. What's going on? Peeps. What's up, peeps? Todd, how's it going? Awesome. Good to see you guys still coming in. Matt Burke. You say what's, you've been here the whole time. Mantra Shrimp Man. Like that name. Anyways, so that's what we're working on. I'm cutting this cutting this stencil back there. We're going to do it pretty quick. I'll be back here in a couple minutes and we'll keep chatting. I think we finished that layer. Also want to just make sure this doesn't turn off. Alright, you guys know I like this fiber tape. Holds my stencils together. Doesn't look like much yet, but trust. A little bit of orange going on. Let's see, we'll just put that right there for now. Okay. All right. get started and have some fun. I'm basically going to take this, which is the black stencil layer. Looks like some crap on it. I'm going to spray the black stencil layer on the canvas as what I call a reference layer so that I kind of see where he's going to sit. It's also fun for you guys because you also get to see what he's going to look like. Thank you. guys can see very. It's kind of like. That's got too much glare. Anyways, it's kind of a. So that is reference layer, kind of an idea of what we're going to be working with. Eventually. I'm going to go check on. Andy is printing out more stencil layers for me. I'm going to go check on the status of that. I'll be right back. Okay, let's see here. So Andy's stencil is not done printing out yet, but let's see this one here. Okay. Love that you guys are all chit-chatting. So right over there, next to the Buster Posey that I'm cutting, there's two more stencils of cards. Actually, I guess I've told you guys that I'm doing them. Mike Trout and Ricky Anderson. So if you guys catch a glimpse of that, might have been accidental on purpose for the OG hot plate. Okay, so I'm going to cut another stencil layer. So basically, let's see. I got to look at the card. Okay, here we go. Yeah, so we got the black border. It's really thin on the bottom and sides. And then a white border inside of that that has rounded corners with a pretty big radius. I should probably, I'll freehand it, or I could trace like a cap. I'll trace something. Okay, so I'm basically cutting now, I'm cutting the layer that is going to be within the card, behind Buster, but in front of the white border and the black border. Just kind of talking myself through it to tell myself what I'm doing as much as you guys. I'm thinking for the background color of Buster behind the figure that you guys see now, I was going to go with blue, and I was thinking it might actually be the same, I might end up going with the same blue that's on my cut card or a similar blue. I think it's going to be nice pairing, matching. I'm going to try and use some consistent colors throughout my entire set. You know, it'll alternate. So like the card that I'm painting now that you guys are seeing, this Buster Posey card, that is actually my fourth card that will be released in top. So you guys have only seen one of my cards. Well, some of you guys have seen multiple. Dope. And you're printing one more? Perfect. Perfect. Thanks, bro. Carlos says no blue. It wouldn't be like Dodger blue, by the way. I get that, like, the Dodgers and, you know, the Giants. Sorry, just reading all your guys' comments. Not on a Giants card. Carlos says no blue. Just so you know, it's like a sky blue. It's not like, I'm not going to do a Dodger blue on the card, just to clarify. But I am pretty set on doing blue, to be honest. So, you know, I do know that I gave you guys a lot of creative control last time around, choosing colors and stuff. That was a lot of fun. I just have this kind of crystal clear vision. And I am putting, like, big, bold, vibrant colors in the background. Oh, Brian also says no blue. Oh, my God. See, the problem is... Derek, too. It's light blue. You guys are tripping out. Oh, God. Yeah, sky blue. Chip says use Dodger blue. Oh, my God. Guys, I'm a Giants fan. This is a Giants Stay Awesome jersey. So, I'm not thinking about blue as Dodger blue. You guys, I don't know, man. Dodger blue would be kind of funny, though. Eric says blue's a bad idea, too. Oh, you guys are killing me. Well, then what color am I going to do the background? Because here's my thinking. Here's a few things. Jarek says Dodger blue all the way. Grant says do whatever I want. Carolina blue is always welcome. It actually is kind of close to Carolina blue. Okay. Kutch was blue. My second card is green. It has a big, very bright green background. And you guys probably know it's an Atlanta Braves player. My third card, super bright yellow. So... which you guys have also seen, if you guys have been watching for a while, because those cards have all been done for a long time, right? So, those colors, I don't want to, like, repeat. Well, I was planning on repeating now, starting back over at blue. And probably doing, like, more greens and yellows and kind of, you know, some stuff like that. But, I don't want to do green, because I have a green card dropping next. And it's even possible that this card could get bumped up to my third card because my third card is a Dodger and I don't really want to drop Dodgers now. And I've even, like, trying to get rid of my Dodgers and Yankees players and swapping them out for some other ones, which we'll talk about separately. Yeah, the card can't be all orange and black. It's going to be a lot of orange and black. It has a black border on the card. He's all in black and orange and gray. So, I don't know, man. I think you guys are wrong. But I'll tell you what. Well, I mean, I'm probably... I don't know. I think you guys should just see what happens. And then, you know, we'll see if you guys like it or not. And if you don't like it, then don't buy it. And then the PR will be low. But I will like it, so I'll have a lot of them. And then a low PR will work to my benefit. So, it's really kind of a win-win. Prince Purple. Ooh, that's kind of interesting. But I just see, like, there's so much black on the card, and if I put purple on there, it's going to be heavily purple and black card, and I don't know. Then it's going to look like Rockies. Tim Dula Blue, we trust you. Oh, you guys. Dustin, yeah, I'm still pretty set on blue, guys, but you guys are really making me second guess it good, so that's fine. My second favorite seltzer flavor, Mandarin. First is this, like, vanilla, orange vanilla. All right, I'm going to cut this out. It doesn't really matter what color we're painting it, because I have to cut out the same part anyways. And we're going to do that. Do you have to do 1971? Oh, my goodness, you guys. Yeah, at this point, I have to do 71. I'm locked in. Got one of your foils, Brody. Nice. That is awesome. I did too. I finally got my Kutch cards today, and I got a couple foils, which is great. So we will be doing cut Jotters at some point, but I have a surprise for that. Is I'm actually going to get my starting in Project 70 with McCutcheon cards. I'm going to have those autos JSA certified, and they're going to have the sticker and a certificate from JSA. And they're going to witness my signature, which is great. So that, I think, will help like for resale and stuff down the road on those cards. But because of that, I just have to wait a tiny bit longer to release the Kutch autos, because I need to sign them, but I need to coordinate with JSA so that they are either present or can meet up or something, and we do that. Anyways, okay, I'm going to go back cut. Can't remember if I have I feel like all my playlists for... Yeah, and if I play Pandora, it's going to get... It's all bad news. Okay, I'm just going to do this. You guys all just listen to your own music, I suppose. I am, just while I'm cutting the stencil, I'm going to have an audiobook playing, because I always do. My phone's already over there. I'm going to be cutting for probably 5 minutes. What signature are you putting on the new Project 70 cards? I'm putting the full Blake signature. Let's see. Is that one of them? It is. Like this. Those are going to be the ones that I do, my like signed numbered ones. I am basically putting this signature on everything this year, but if somebody wants to do like TTM autos and mail in their own cards, pay $20 a base card, I will do the old signature on Project 70 cards if you prefer it. But if you don't specify, that is the signature we're going with. And part of the reason is because I want to have more name recognition for Blake, and I do think this signature is cool. I will still use it in some circumstances, but I think getting this, I think that's fun. And I like the idea of changing my signature every year, so that then you can kind of know, oh, that's, that was a 2020 Blake piece because of the signature that it has. So maybe I'll change it again next year. Maybe I'll write the full, I'll get longer and longer. Blake J, Blake Jamieson, Blake Loftus Jamieson. Yeah. All right. Well, let's see here. I think we're ready. I think we're ready to rock. I'm gonna cut. We're gonna get after it, and then hopefully, once I get this one cut, and then Andy's bringing in one more, I have to cut the skin tones. Once we start painting, and you guys know if you guys have seen me paint, once we're like spray painting, things go pretty quickly. And we're also going to do silk screen on this one. We're going to do the kind of Louis Vuitton baseball cool pattern that I made that is in all of my Topps Project 70 cards. It's also on the back of the 1951 cards. And so we're going to put this on the card as well. Probably on his like jersey and chest protector. I haven't decided yet. Okay, cut time. I just saw Tess asked if I could turn up the volume, so I'm turning up the volume. Obviously, that won't really help till I come back, but... want to see how thick I should make this white border. It's pretty thin. Could make it a little bigger, though. Looking for a ruler.
Yo, Andy. Oh, never mind, I found it.
Reorganized today, so I don't know where stuff is. I need something round that I can trace for the corners. Sorry about that, guys. Hopefully I hasn't been off for too long. I guess I'll probably find out soon if Tess texts me. We're almost done cutting.
Let me check on these comments. There we go.
Show you guys what we got going. So now we have cut out for basically behind Buster. Dodger blue, of course. Thank you.
up, Ski? By the way, everybody, Ski's drop.
When is it?
Oh, no, it's way past the third drop, I think, already. That was 9 o'clock Eastern. I got in on the second drop. I was late on the first. It was sold out. He did companions. He did autos, babe autos. And he's doing his babe autos with, like, the gold is an insert. Everybody buys the base, which I think is really cool. Props to you. And the companions look freaking gorgeous. I'm going to hit you up to chat on the sidebar about that, too.
All right. Let's see here.
So far, progress, slow, but happening. Yo, Andy, can you do one more? Do the black border. We're going to paint it black and mask it off. Then we're going to let that dry. I'm going to take the tape off, and then I'm actually going to tape on top of it. And then we're going to finish the painting. And slowly. But
that is the plan.
All right, we're making progress. How we doing, guys? Is he on mute? No, I'm not on mute. I'm just kind of working in the zone and letting you guys listen to whatever music you want. I do have an AirPod in. I'm listening to a zombie book, actually. It's called it's the Mountain Man series by Keith C. Blackmore, narrated by R.C. Bray, my favorite narrator, hands down, on Audible. He's super dope. Yeah, so that's what I'm listening to, a zombie book, over there cutting stencils, painting stuff. It's pretty great, actually. Oh, thank you, Dustin. I appreciate that. Yeah, the border's always fun. And it's sometimes like, this time is a little bit different than I'm doing it first. I might regret that later because I'm going to basically mask off the border when I paint the portrait. I guess we're going to find out. Octavius says the left border's a little wider. So it's actually, it's closer. It actually does look a little bit wider. But if you look at my cards, because of this, what is it? The aspect ratio of a baseball card is slightly different than this 30 by 40 canvas. So I actually have wiggle room on both sides. So both sides are going to be coming in. What's going to happen is, because you're right, that left side is more, a little bit wider, it's a little off center, I'll just crop it a little tighter on that side for the print file. So the print file will be centered. But, you know, it's also cool. Like, I love having these originals, and like, the originals are a little bit unique, right? So this one might be off center. The McCutcheon card has the Liberty Bell, right? Is that the Philadelphia Bell with the crack in it? Has the bell, which the team made me take off the card because it didn't match the font, the logo font that I had used for like the decade, which is annoying. But anyways, the originals have like kind of this character, and this particular piece is going to have some character where it's a little bit off center. But the final one will be fine. Yeah, like a true top start. You know, to be honest, I mean, if I just submit it like this, we might end up with some really well-centered cards. You know, I'll tell you this too. Speaking of centering, I got a foil today. I got a few foils of my McCutcheon card. I got foil number 1 out of 70, and it's pretty bad off-center. Like, Eric would say it's horrible. I think it's like moderate, but like it's definitely not great. And I can't believe that number 1 of 70 is off center, but whatever. Did I pick all my boards yet? The years that I'm doing? Yes. So basically, we have picked all the artists. We have picked the year that we're inspired by, paired with the player, and those matchups. Now, I'm changing a couple things, but I'm not changing the years. I'm just changing the teams because I want to do a couple less Yankees and Dodgers and more other teams and players. Although one of the switches I think I'm going to make is, I don't know if I'll drop Jeter, but maybe drop Jeter and pick up Don Mattingly, but do Don Mattingly on Miami, because Miami has zero representation right now. Ski, you got 1. Wow. So I got 5, and I ordered 300 cards. And it's crazy because we opened them today, and I was getting pissed because it took a while, me and Andy, to open 300 cards. Takes a long time. And like, we opened 2.5 boxes. We had 3 boxes total before we got a single foil. And I thought we might go 300 without getting one. And I was gonna be pissed. But they came through, so they had 5. And they were like all in a row, like at the end of the box. So obviously I think that Topps pulled some strings just to make sure that I basically got, because I bought 300 cards, I think getting five is actually a little bit, I don't know, less than, I don't know. I think, because it depends on the print run, right? Because there's 70 of those. My print was 3,800. So yeah, like every like 50-ish cards, I think, potentially, by the odds, should be a foil. So 5 was good. Yeah, Mattingly Marlins card, manager of the year, that'd be fire. Yeah,
I think that's a good idea. I like that. Yeah. We get discounts. Don't they mark on the packing slip that you get a foil? Sometimes. I got a foil that wasn't marked, and I got foils that were marked. Because I also pulled a foil of Gregory Siff, which I'm so pumped about. In fact, I think I have that right here. Check this out. I was so hyped. I only ordered two of these, and I got a foil. That was so lucky. Greg's like, I mean, you guys know. Greg's the OG. He's the homie. All right, I'm going to go see if this, let's see how dry this paint is, I suppose. Sorry, I guess it went for another half an hour because that shuts off every half hour. So, we're getting closer. The border's looking sick. I'm pretty happy with it. I'm going to, while that's drying, because that's definitely going to take a minute, I put it on kind of thick. I'm going to cut the skin tone stencil, which will be one of the next stencils that we do. And Peanuts World, you're absolutely right. Matt Taylor's Jose Canseco card was fire today. Really good. I would say one of my top, definitely top five of cards so far in the set. I'm also biased because, like, you know, I grew up on the Bash Brothers, but yeah, it's really nice.
Skin tones it is. Next. Thank you. not 100% sure if I'm going to need that one, but I definitely don't need more.
Great. Exactly what I want to hear.
So. Unfortunately fell off right when I was done. Keep that layer. Paint's drying. I'm gonna use the bathroom. I'll be right back. And then I'm going to jump in the comments, too. If you guys have questions about it, ideas, thoughts, whatever, put them in the comments. I'll be right back.
What is up, guys? Nice. Oh, wow. Tim, you already got the party of Cunha. That was fast. Heavy J, take it easy, man. Thank you. Appreciate everything you do. You the man. Posse Ricky looks so good, man. Oh, that's definitely a top five card for me. Eric's out. F dot. Later, buddy. Yeah, 1 in 55 should be the ratio. Yeah, so I was about that. All right, I think I'm pretty caught up. Big Red asks, are those stencil layers just paper? I'm guessing they're printed on a plotter. They are just paper, and they're printed on an Epson SureColor P9000, which is a pretty large commercial-grade printer. I print on just regular computer paper. I turn the opacity usually pretty far down so that I'm not using as much ink as if I was painting full black and white. And then I put this mesh on top called fiber tape. Oh, wow, Grant, congrats. 2 weeks from the house being done. That must feel good. Yeah, so Big Red, they're just, they're on regular printer paper. And so before, I have a printer here at my house now, but I used to just go to FedEx and print there, because FedEx print and ship centers oftentimes have a 36-inch wide format printer that is self-serve and is 75 cents a square foot. So I would just drive down to FedEx and print all the stencils that I need, bring them, and I'd usually print a couple extras and bring them home, so if I messed up cutting them, I wouldn't have to drive back. But yeah, it's a fun process. Okay, so let's see here. I'm gonna check on the paint. We got a good amount of us still. That's great. All right, I'm gonna check it on, and we're gonna keep going. So this time, this layer, which is going to be the gray mid-tone, we're putting it on almost everything. I did not put the fiber tape on because it doesn't have any islands. I don't really want to go into it that much more than that, but I don't need the fiber tape to hold everything together. I can just stick it on like this. So I'm just going to do that for a couple reasons with this particular layer. Number one, we won't have this mesh. We're gonna get a really solid color, which I think is good for the base of this car, or for the base of like the paint. And then I'm gonna use this same cutout stencil, and we're gonna do a silk screen while this is on it. So everything that I'm painting gray right now is gonna end up with like a silver pattern on it. You guys will see. So because I'm gonna silk screen on it, I can't put fiber tape on it because it wouldn't work.
sometimes. So we've already, I mean, this is going to end up being like, I don't know, we're going to be on 5-layer stencil or something. 6. So with this, his chest protector is like black. And then his jersey is the gray. And so, even though, come on, focus. I get to take this out. There we go. So I'm basically doing 2 different colors in 1 layer. Normally a layer is just sometimes a single color, sometimes not. This time not. Okay, so for the next part, where we're going to do some silk screening, we're going to have to do it on the floor, so I'm going to, like, I'll tilt the camera down, but we definitely got to let this dry for a minute, but I think it's going to be, I can see it in my head, it's going to be great, I'm very excited about this piece.
All right, night, Matt. You'll see some pictures tomorrow. Let's see here. Ooh, orange, clay orange and brown. That is actually a good idea. Just checking out some of your guys' retweets. Thank you, guys. I appreciate that. Okay, we got crowd. We're popping off right now. So, like I said, we're going to silk screen. We're going to use the kind of Louis Vuitton-looking pattern. Andy hopefully is going to help me hold it. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna start setting up for that while this is drying. While that is drying. My Cunha is dropping on Monday the 15th, which is in just a couple days. So that's exciting. And it's sick, and it's right down there in my hallway. I can see it right now. It's beautiful. Here is the silk screen. So this is making it into everything that I work on these days, baseball related, I try and work it in. It's the back of my 1951 cards. It's on every single Project 70 card in different spots. In my next card, my Acuna, it's like on the background. In this, kind of like the Jeter that I did, if you guys remember that. All the other ones I think are just on the jerseys. But this one we're going to do on the jersey and helmet. And
like I said, we're gonna switch to the floor in a minute when I'm ready. Calling an audible. We're gonna do orange pattern, so it's gonna be like this whole thing's gonna be all decked out. I think it's gonna be fire. I don't know why the black bears. So that's what we're gonna do. Mainly also because we don't have gray or silver.
It should look really clear.
Yeah, it looks great because the things in there. Okay, so we're gonna do this. Alright, let's see here. Let's get this here.
You should hook up your AirPods to the microphone.
There you go. Oh, that'd be kind of a good idea. I'm listening to an audio book though. But yes, that would be very smart. Okay. There.
That's straight. Why don't you put it flush to the canvas and then move it back here? I can actually see. Here, do you want a ruler?
I don't know why I got it.
Okay.
It's awesome.
Great.
So.
Yeah, I have it out here. We have like a spoon or a fork or something.
Okay, really nice and bright. Don't worry, guys. It'll offset the blue that we have.
probably something that I wish that I had told you, asked you about when you were a Blick, is the hinges. They have like little clamps, the hinges that you can bolt down, so like we could put it on the table and that, and then we could put blocks and like every time it like clamps.
That'd be great. What is that called? I feel like you're better off. You could always scoot it back into the container.
That's true.
They're at the bottom of this.
Oh, Chris.
That's good.
Right. Okay.
Okay. So it's funny, it got so much darker, like, on this. You know, like, that's so subtle.
It's strange.
Well, it's just that I just should have pushed harder in the middle. I think that we should do it again.
I feel like you should pin over the first your feet and wash this out.
I don't think so.
No? Okay.
I can always pin over it.
Sure.
After.
Because I think it's going to stick to the bottom.
Of course it is. Just see what it looks like. Oh yeah. Fire.
Oh, it's dope.
Yeah, it looks great.
Yeah. Perfect.
Dope. Okay. It's hard to tell, but it works really well.
Honestly, that's the best thing that's ever come out.
Yeah, it came out really nice. You wanted to go wash it out.
I think
we should put that. Let me grab some other canvases. Those
oh,
ones
you want to use it?
Yeah.
Might as well. Oh, dope.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, so that's going to take a minute to dry, which is great. It looks awesome. I'm going to put it in front of a heater, and then we're going to silk screen and just use the rest of the ink on some abstracts that I've been working on. You'll get to see a sneak peek.
I can take this off. Oh. Oh, bro. That's gonna be so fire! Oh my god. Could just be a Fucci already.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, guys, check this out. So far.
Fire.
Okay. Alright, I do want to put this with the heater. But we'll put the heater over here. Okay. All right.
Yeah, that's gonna be looking dope. Yeah.
Okay. Just tweeting this real quick. YouTube.com/make. Okay. All right, guys. Next painting.
Well, not really, man.
Yeah, I guess.
Are you gonna do that one section? Or are you just gonna go over the whole thing?
I'll go over the whole thing and just see what sticks.
You gotta grab this so it doesn't stick first?
Sure. Yeah.
I was hoping it actually would
streak.
Yeah.
Oh wow, it like barely popped up. Yeah, it's a little bit though.
That's okay.
I didn't honestly feel like it's better off probably.
Yeah. Okay. However it lays down, I don't care. It doesn't have to be perfect at all. Just lay it straight down.
Oh God.
Oh God. Oh God. I like that it's like an abstract piece, so it doesn't have to be perfectly straight. Okay, so I'm just gonna go.
Let's see here. How do I like it? Screen it off?
Yeah.
There we go. Should have a cool pattern. Help.
Yeah. Oh, that's pretty dope.
Mm-hmm. Alright. Are we all done here?
Can you see it all? Yeah.
Yeah, isn't it dope?
Yeah, whoa! Oh my God, you guys gotta see this!
Yeah. Alright.
Sweet. Thank you, bro.
Oh, that's pretty fire.
Okay.
Okay, so yeah, just a little abstract.
It's hard to kind of see the texture, but
it's pretty great. Pretty great, I think. Okay.
Killing this. Oh, shit. What's that?
So cool. So the silk screening takes a little while to dry, unfortunately, but I got a heater running on it. I could turn a fan on it. I told you guys I want to finish this car tonight, and I mean that. So it is going to be just a minute before we can paint again. But I think it's going really cool. I think the fact that I didn't have a silver or gray for the pattern ended up working to our advantage, because I think the orange looks awesome. So that's great. Am I going to incorporate the paint bucket spin technique into a Project 70 card? Probably not, Carlos. I've got a system. I want all these cards to be really like a really complete set together, nice set together, consistent. And, you know, it's things that I learned during Project 2020. So I experimented a lot in Project 2020, which is great. Now I'm just kind of like, okay, this is how I'm doing the card, just within the scope of this set. But I do love the spinning bucket, and it's super fun to do. So I'll definitely do more of it and like stream it and stuff. I'm just not going to put it on a card. KT cards, what's going on? Yeah, Dustin, man. Dustin, you have amazing work. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that, Jimmy. It's going to be really cool, I think. I'm very, very, very happy with how it's coming so far. We just need to dry faster.
case you guys are just coming in. Here's where we're at so far. So far we have a Fucci card. It's gonna look sick. I think we're ready, guys.
It's a little bit wet on the bottom. That's all. Then we're good. Okay, so if I put it sideways like this. So pretty soon,
Scott, yeah, me too, man. Always watching paint dry. Oh, wow, KT Cards, thank you so much, man. I really, really appreciate that. Totally unnecessary, but also totally appreciated. Yeah, it was really nice. What has been my favorite part about interacting with your fans and new customers? Go Big Hurt, Frank Thomas. I think it's been really fun, like, trading with people online. That's been a really fun thing. You know, I was out of the hobby for so long, and now being back on and, like, doing trades to help finish my P2020 set and other people's sets or people pull parallels. You know, I've been trading for these like crazy. Trying to trade for as many as possible, but you know, buying them if people need money or prefer money over something I can give them. So I think that's like been my favorite part. It's like the trading aspect, man. I love the barter system. If it was up to me, that's how it would all be. I've resisted all P2020 cards. Wow. Oh, that's your PC. That's awesome. Thank you, KT. I appreciate that. Yeah, this is going to be a really cool POSEY card, I think. It's going to turn out dope. Okay, I need to look up. Okay, so for the 71 card, let's see here. Here's the Giants one. Okay. So the Giants is going to be white. The name Buster POSEY is going to be orange. On the Willie Mays card, it says outfield in yellow. I think that's probably the move. And then the dot in the middle is the green. Oh, there's no dot because his head's in the way. Yeah, yellow and orange. Okay, I need to find the orange that I'm going to use for the Giants orange. And then we're going to get the white ready. We're getting close. It doesn't look like it that much because it just looks like a blob right now. But we're actually like very close to a finished painting. So bear with me, guys. We got probably, it's 12:30 now. Half an hour. Maybe half an hour, I think. Could be a little longer, could be faster, but that's my guess.
Okay, next stencil layer is up. This is going to be the orange. I'm going to sweep my studio. I gotta get this right.
I was wrong on a couple 51 cards. I had to go back and change. Buster Posey's eyes. I think they're blue. Hazel green. Interesting. Really? See some of these photos. I mean, that shit looks blue to me. Yeah, it's kind of like a gray blue. Yeah, okay. Cool. All right.
So I like it, but I think the orange I picked is a tiny bit too dark. I'm gonna put this stencil back on. I'm gonna make it a tiny bit lighter. Getting closer, guys. So I used a few different shades of orange, and so there's like, let's see if I can show you a good example. Like in the helmet, you can see like a little bit of splatter. I just like that texture. Also adding like this is like a highlight on the picture, so just adding a little yellow paint, tiny bit, just to give it a little highlight. It's hard to see it. But that's what we're doing. All right, now we gotta wait for paint to dry again for just a couple minutes. We got two layers left. We have a white layer, and then we have the black layer. And then we're done. spray paint because it dries so fast. I went to the bathroom, I got a drink, bam. Now we can paint the next layer. Okay, so we're doing white and... Sorry about that, guys. We're back.
so sick.
One more layer of paint. That's the black layer. That's the one that really ties it all together and makes it look super dope. And I'm really happy with how it looks already. So we're going to get to that in just a second. And then, then we're done. Get a little hair color in there. All
a screenshot. Here's the one. I think it came out cool. There's a few things, looking at it now, if I'm being honest, I wish that the highlight on the skin, I wish that I did that one shade darker. So it's a little closer to this. I stepped down two shades. I should have stepped down one shade instead of two shades. I might redo that before I launch the card, because I have a few cards before this. But I think overall, first attempt, I think this came out fantastic. And I really, really like how, like, the pattern is very subtly, but it's in everything. And it's on his pants. It's on his little... It's on there. It's everywhere. It's on the helmet. Actually, that's pretty fire. So I really like... That's my favorite part about it, I think. And the fact that Dustin took this photo... And knowing the photographer. That's my other favorite part about this. But I think we're on to something, and that was super fun. It's been a really long time since I painted on a live stream. I think we're going to do that more often. It might not always be Project 70 stuff, because I'm going to go like 52 more weeks and I only have 16 more cards to paint or something like that. So, you know. But we'll paint more stuff. If you guys like this, I had a blast. Thank you guys so much. I'll sign off on this screen right here.
Oh, man. Yeah. So I'm into it. I had a really good time. I mean, I love painting. That's why I do it. But thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate you guys spending your time with me. You know, it was a good time. Stay safe, stay healthy, and stay awesome, and stay ready for Monday the 15th when my next card drops. And that's pretty much it. All right. Love you guys. Bye. Stay awesome.